Let's take a look now at what is considered to be a balk. And a balk is when a pitcher makes an action where he tries to deceive a runner on base. And so generally the penalty, once the umpire calls a balk, is that each runner will get to move up one base. They'll all advance to the next base automatically. So let's look at what is to be considered balk. The first situation is when the pitcher, when he's on the mound and he has his foot on the rubber, he makes any motion usually associated with his pitch and fails to make the delivery. So he makes a motion associated with his delivery and fails to make the pitch. And so maybe this is something, maybe if the pitcher gets halfway through his windup and for whatever reason he would stop, then he would be called for the balk. The next way is that he would fake a throw to first base. And this is, if referring to, is if he's making a pickoff move or faking a pickoff move. And So one thing to note is that he can fake to other bases. He could fake to third base or second base, but he cannot fake to first base. And there's one exception to that, and that's if he does something called a step to third and then look to first, or he would actually step toward third base and then spin around and step toward first, and then he's allowed. He would not have to throw the ball in that occasion, but he can't just fake a throw if he steps toward first base. The third way is that the pitcher, while he's on his rubber, fails to step directly toward a base before throwing to that base. So he fails to step directly toward a base before throwing to that base. And so this is just making sure that the pitcher, number one, is that he has to step before he throws the ball. He can't throw the ball and then take a step, and he can't throw the ball without stepping. And then the next thing, and this is saying, so then he can't say he can't step up here toward home plate and then throw the ball over to first base. That would be exactly what a balk is referring to, which is deceiving the runner. The next way is that the pitcher would either throw or fake a throw to an unoccupied base. Throws or fakes a throw to an unoccupied base. And this is with the exception if he's attempting to make a play. So that the second part, if he's attempting to make a play, would be something like if the rule says if there is a runner on first base, the pitcher can spin around and throw the ball toward second base. Maybe if the runner on first would break for second base and he's attempting to steal second base, then the pitcher is allowed to throw the ball to second base, which would obviously be unoccupied, as long as he doesn't hesitate on first base. And the final way that we can take a look at in this video is that if the pitcher is to make a motion associated with his pitch while he is not touching the rubber. Makes a motion associated with his pitch while not touching the rubber, the pitcher's rubber. So this is something we looked at, that he must always have that his pivot foot on the rubber. It must always be making contact. And so if he for whatever reason standing beside or behind the rubber, he's not allowed to make any motion associated with his pitch, or it is then a balk. So those are a few ways that a pitcher can be called for a balk, and we'll take a look at a few more in the next video.